Hello. This is a part two of the our Easter decorations, and it's we call it excellent surprise Easter. So what we have is, as I said in the part one, we use one box of a white cupcake mix or white cake mix. I did use actually butter cake, which is you can use vanilla as well. Except is what you do instead of 2 eggs whole, use 3 whites of an egg to make it white butter. So we tinted it with the leaf green gel food coloring and deep pink gel food coloring. Leave it third one as it is white. So we'll bake it in sandwich baking tin for about roughly 20 minutes or so. Probably if you, because it took me less, because I only took half of cake butter, because first of we prepare for part one. So what we do is here, we want crumble, but not a fine crumble, just a little, just making just a big crumble sort of. See, that's it, that's what we wanted, no more, because we want to see actual difference in this beautiful crumble. So what we do is, that's good enough, because we want to see colors. So what we do is next, we have a little bit of melted white chocolate. We don't really need much. So what we do, it's probably would be enough for one box of cake mix. We probably would use about 1/4 of melted white chocolate. So what we do, we add, I add 1 big tablespoon for start, because I have smaller, just a half of size of a normal cake mix. What we do is we incorporate it all together and shape it as an egg. Once you mix them up, as I said before, do not crumble too much, otherwise you can't see very well colors. Adding more of melted white chocolate to make sure you actually able to press mixture together. It's not only easier, it's also tastier too. Oops, they started collapsing my little eggs. I just placed them a second ago. This plate would be probably not very good choice, because it's better to get a plate which is they can actually hold in this sort of position. So once you're done, don't make them hugely large as well. So what we do is here, we'll make it, just form it as you think would be egg look like. So what we do is next, we take a lollipop, dip into melted white chocolate, insert it inside, and we place on a plate here. Then what we do is, once you've done them all, you probably will get a lot, depending on size you're making. You could make 12, you could make 24 of them. It's if you make them small, you can make even 30. So it just depends what size you make those eggs, basically. So what we do is next, once we insert it, we have to place it in a refrigerator for 10 minutes to set and harden. After 10 minutes in the fridge, our cake pops are nicely set. What we do is next is we have white melted chocolate. If it's a little bit thick, add vegetable oil to make it more manageable. So what we do is we dip inside. Don't twist too much, otherwise it could come off. And what we do, we leave it here to set. So what we do is next, I like to use not much really things, just like nice and simple. This is just a sugar roses icing decoration you can buy from a supermarket. They come in a different colors. So what we do is we take one, once we've done all our white chocolate. So what we do, we just take, say for example, this is like a light salad greenish color. and apply on top of the our cake. Well, it's not a cake pop really, it's sort of like a, well, we can call it cake pop really, isn't it? Yeah. So what we do is have a look what's best of all for this sort of color would be. I think it's probably this color be suited well. Place it on top. So and like this you can go and do much more different ones. For example, blue. They come in a different colors. They come in yellow, in a red. I have a box which is comes in green, blue, and kind of like a cherry kind of color. So once you're happy how much you apply and how much it's shining, place it to set. It's actually not quite set such as yet. So what we do, and we can place one of yellow roses, because blue and yellow goes well. So let's finish up with all of them. As you can see, we finish with some of decorations of our excellent surprise, because this one, I actually cut it a little piece inside to make sure you're able to have a look that it's actual layers of these three different colors. See, what I would like to say, so if you like to make this sort of recipe, don't crumble your cake too much, just to kind of hold it together and shape it into egg, to make sure you not mix too much colors. You want actually colors, to see actual colors inside your cake pops. So what you do, have a big chunks of cake and just apply some of melted white chocolate and press them together. So I hope you do like it, this sort of idea. And also for more decoration of this cake pops, what you can do also, you can use a different color, writing icing or making icing mixture and pipe out in a different design as you like. As well as if you have a different color candy melts, you can dip them instead of using white chocolate, which is ultimately will be different color straight away. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Everything will be in the description box. Until next time, goodbye.